Hello students, this is the fifth video for Maths class 7. We will be covering triangles now. So question number 1, find the area of the triangle having base 16 cm and height 7.5 cm. We know the formula for calculating area of a triangle is area is equal to half into base into height. So here area will be half into base is 16 cm. Multiplied by height is 7.5 cm. So area is 60 cm square. This was quite easy. Now moving on to the second question. Find the altitude of the triangle when its area is 28.9 meter square and its base is 8.5 meter. Now what do we mean by altitude? Altitude means height. So here area and base is given. We have to calculate height. So the formula for area is half into base into height. So in order to calculate height, we have to take it on the other side of the equal to sign. We have to make this the subject and the other variables will be coming to the other side of the equal to sign. So height is equal to area into 2 divided by base. So this is equal to 28.9 into 2 divided by base is 8.5. So height is equal to 6.8 meter. Now look at the third question. Find the area of the triangle whose sides are 13 cm, 20 cm and 21 cm. Also find the height of the triangle corresponding to the largest side. Okay, first of all we will calculate the area. See here, the three sides of the triangle are given. Base and height is not given. Okay, we can consider one of these as base but we don't know what the height of the triangle is. So we won't be using the formula area equals to half into base into height. Instead of that, we will be using the Heron's formula. So the Heron's formula is area is equal to square root over S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. But here first we have to define what A, B and C are. So A, B and C are the three sides of the triangle. So here A is 13 cm, B is 20 cm and C is 21 cm. So S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. So S will be 13 plus 20 plus 21 divided by 2, which comes to 54 by 2, that is 27 cm. So we got all these values, we can now put the values in this formula and we can find the answer. So area is S, that is 27 cm into S minus A. So S is 27 minus A is 13 into again S minus B. So 27 minus 20, then S minus C, that is 27 minus 21. So on solving this we get square root over 27 into 27 minus 13 is 14 into 27 minus 20 is 7 into 27 minus 21 is 6. Now here after this you can either multiply all these numbers and then find the square root or you can find the factors of each number and then you can write it down here and you can take out the common factors from the square root. So I've done this in this process, you can also multiply this and then find the square root. So the factors of 27 are 3 into 3 into 3, that makes 27. The factors for 14 is 2 into 7, 7 is a prime factor, so we will write 7 directly here. And 6, we get 2 into 3. So from here, we will be taking out the pairs, like you can see 3 into 3. One pair of 3, we will take this out here. One pair of 7, we have taken this out here. Again, 3 and 3, we have taken this out here. And 2 into 2, we have taken this out here. So, 3 into 3 into 7 into 2. This comes to 3 into 3 is 9, 7 into 2 is 14. So, 9 into 14, you get 126 centimeters square. So, this is our area. And this is the answer to the first part. Now, look at the second part of the question. Also, find the height of the triangle corresponding to the largest side. Okay, so here we have got the area is 126 centimeters square. We know the formula for calculating area of triangle is half into base into height. From here, we have to calculate the height. So, we will be taking height on the other side and all the other variables on one side. So, height will be equal to area into 2 by base. Area is 126 into 2 by base. Now what is base here? In the question it is mentioned to calculate height corresponding to the largest side of the triangle. which is the largest side among these three? The largest side is 21. So we have taken 21 as base. So if you solve this, you will get the value for height is 12 cm. Now look at the next question. The base and height of a triangle are in the ratio 5:3 and its area is 43.2 meters square. Find the base and the height of the triangle. Here the ratio of base and height is given and the area is given. So ratio is 5:3 and area is 43.2 meters square. These two things are given in the question. Now let us take the common factor as x. Then our base will be 5x and our height will be 3x. So area is half into base into height. The value for area is 43.2 is equal to half into base is 5x into height is 3x. Now if we solve this, we get 43.2. This half, if it comes here, it becomes, we have to multiply this with 2. Now if this half, if it comes here, we have to multiply this side by 2. So 43.2 into 2 is equal to 5x into 3x. So this becomes 86.4 is equal to 15 and x into x is x squared. So here we get x squared is equal to 86.4 by 15. If we remove the decimal sign, we get a 10 here in the denominator. So x squared is equal to 864 by 150. Now if we simplify this, or if we reduce it in the simplest form, we get x squared is equal to 144 by 25. And removing the square from this side, we will be getting the square root over on the other side. So x is equal to square root over 144 by 25. So x is equal to 12 by 5, because 144 is 12 square and 25 is 5 square. So 12 by 5, which comes to 2.4. So the value of x is 2.4. Now we will use this value of x to calculate our base and height. So base will be, we know that base is 5x, so base will be 5 into the value of x, that is 2.4. So it comes to 12 meter and height is 3x, so 3 into the value of x, that is 2.4. So height is 3 into 2.4, that is 7.2 meter. Now let us look at the derivation for calculating the area of an equilateral triangle. Here we have a triangle ABC and here all the sides are equal, that is A. Now if we drop a perpendicular AD on BC, what happens? This AD will divide BC into two equal halves, that is BD will be equal to DC. We know the base here BC is A, so BD will be A by 2 and DC will be A by 2. Now in order to calculate the area for any triangle, we use the formula half into base into height. So we have the base here BC and height AD. We know the value of base, that is the value of BC is A, and the value of AD is unknown. So we have to calculate the value of AD first. So how do we calculate this AD? If you see, this AD is dividing the triangle ABC into two equal triangles, that is triangle ABD and triangle ACD. So we can take any one of the triangles. Here I am taking triangle ABD. So, and we can use Pythagoras theorem to calculate AD, because the other two sides are already given. So by using Pythagoras theorem, we know that Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus height square. So here the base is BD and height is AD and hypotenuse is AB. So AB square is equal to BD square plus AD square. We have to calculate the height here. So we will take this on the other side. So AD square is equal to AB square minus BD square. So AD square is equal to AB square here is, AB is A. So it becomes A square minus BD is A by 2. So this becomes A square by 2 square. So AD square is equal to A square minus, if you square this term, it becomes A square by 2 square is 4. Now AD square is equal to, if you take the LCM, nothing is given here in the denominator, so it becomes 1. If you take the LCM, it becomes 4. So 4A squared minus A squared by 4. AD squared is equal to 3A squared by 4. So AD is square root over 3A squared by 4. So we can take out the perfect square terms, and root 3 is not a, since root 3 is not a perfect square, we can keep this in root. So AD is root 3 by A, root 3 A by 2. Now area is equal to half into base into height. Here base is BC and height is AD. So area will be half into BC is A into height, AD is root 3 A by 2. So root 3 A by 2. Now if you solve this, look at the numerators. 1 into A into root 3 A. So root 3 into 1 is root 3. A into A is A square. Divided by the denominators are 2 into 2. So denominator will be 4. Now this, we can simply use this formula for calculating the area of an equilateral triangle. Whenever one of the, even one of the sides of the equilateral triangle is given, we don't have to use half into base into height formula, because height is not given. If one of the sides are given and height is not given, we can simply use this formula. And Heron's formula would also be very lengthy. So we will just be memorizing this formula, that is area of equilateral triangle is root 3 a square by 4, and we will be using this from now on. Now let us look at a question which is based on this formula. Find the area and height of an equilateral triangle whose each side measures 12 cm. See here, the sides are given. Sides are 12 cm. Height is not given. We have to calculate the area and height. So we cannot use this formula to calculate the area because height is not given. So we will be using the formula for calculating the area of equilateral triangle. That is, area is root 3 a square by 4. So a is nearest 12 cm. And we can put the value 1.73 instead of root 3. So area is 1.73 into a square, that is 12 into 12 by 4. If you solve this, you'll be getting 62.28 centimeters square. Now we know the area, we have to calculate height. We already have base. Base is 12. So height will be area into 2 by base. Height will be area is 62.28 centimeters square into 2 divided by base is 12. So height is 10.38 centimeter. Now here are some questions. I'm reading it out for you. Number 1, a hall is 16 meter long and 12 meter broad. Find the cost of carpeting it at rupees 615 per meter square after leaving a margin of 1 meter all around. You have to solve this question in your copy, and the answer you will get is rupees 47,430. Now question number 2, find the area of the triangle whose sides are 50 cm, 48 cm and 14 cm. Find the height of the triangle corresponding to the side measuring 48 cm. This is again the same, a similar question which I have done today. So you have to solve this in your copy, and the answer you will be getting for area, it is 336 centimeters square, and the height will be 14 centimeters. Remember one thing, in this question, when you are using base, in the question which I have taught you in today's video, we have taken the largest side. But here you have to take the base as 48 centimeters.